Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martihecatso for the headlines. Weather forecast. Easterlies affecting Mindanao. Local news. 150 sacks of garbage collected. BFAR Davao wants versus fishing using chemicals. Over 60 licensed foster parents, foster families, 82 kids in foster care in Davao. TESDA sa barangay aims to boost communities. National news. Study shows degrading state of marine life in Philippine Sandy Cay. U.S., Japan, Australia, Philippines call out China over activities in WPS. International news. North Korea weapons are killing Ukrainians. The implications are far bigger. Three arrested and charged over Sikh activists killing in Canada. Entertainment news. Family firm turning unwanted pianos into art. Baltus 5 legacy returns to GMA this May 6. For the sports, Tots Carlos Creamline eliminate Cherry Tigo on the way to another finals appearance. Arsenal left praying while Man City shines and end game nears. Featured stories. Cuba remote nature paradise. Halo Halo, the original Mikos Mikos of the Philippine pop culture. Side story. And the trivia. Do you know that Davao City is known for its thriving eagle conservation programs? Weather forecast. Mindanao will be partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain shower and thunderstorm due to easterlies localized thunderstorms. Light to moderate winds from east to northeast with slight to moderate seas. Local news. An official from Auxiliary Service Unit, ASU, of Davao City said that they collected around 150 sacks of garbage during their cleanup activity on Saturday, April 27, 2024, along the Agro-Industrial Foundation College of the Philippines, Agro, approaching Felcris Centrale. Paul Bermejo, ASU head, said that the Bantay Dagat volunteers cleaned the area where residents have made it an open dumping site and collected about 148 sacks of mixed garbage and 8 sacks of bottles. Meanwhile, Bermejo expressed that the number of sacks of garbage they gathered has lessened since the onset of the El Nino phenomenon. On average, the office gathers around 2,600 sacks every month during their monthly Saturday cleanups, where around 300 Bantay Dagat volunteers participated. He also revealed that because of the video uploaded online by a netizen of a Baguio couple dumping garbage along the coastal road, Davao City Mayor Sebastian Baste Duterte called the attention of his unit and Senro to form a team that will respond to the situation. In the third week of April, the office conducted a dialogue with the Baguio community, and the local community pledged not to do it again. The Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources Davao Region, BFAR Davao, warned the public against using noxious substances in catching fish. Of this violates Republic Act number 10654, otherwise known as the Philippine Fisheries Code of 1998. In a statement released on April 30, 2024, BFAR Davao reminded the public that catching fish by using harmful chemicals violates Section 92 of the Philippine Fisheries Code of 1998, which states that it shall be unlawful for any person to catch, take, or gather, or cause to be caught, taken, or gathered fish or any fisheries species in the Philippines waters with the use of explosive, noxious, or poisonous substances such as sodium cyanide, which will kill, stupefy, disable, and render unconscious fish in fishery species. This comes from the agency received reports on April 29 about two individuals who are allegedly using harmful substances along the shoreline of the Hican Mati Davao Oriental last April 27. An official from the Capacity Building Unit of the Regional Alternative Child Care Davao or Office of Davao Region, RACO Davao, revealed that there are about 60 licensed poster families in the Davao region. Shena Laika M. Dololasa, in charge of the Capacity Building Unit of RACO Davao, said during the Kapihan sa PIA on Friday morning, May 3, 2024, at NCC Victoria Plaza, Davao City, that as of present, there are 62 licensed foster families and 82 children under foster care in the region. Dulosa emphasized the difference between foster care and adoption. Adoption is a permanent placement of the children, while foster care is an alternative child care program, which is a temporary placement of the children who are neglected, abused, abandoned, and in other special circumstances to licensed foster families. The Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, TESDA, strengthens communities through its training programs by institutionalizing TESDA sa barangay. The program is an initiative and a flagship program of Secretary Suharto Magudadato, which is focused on benefiting 1.2 million Filipinos through mainstreaming technical vocation, education, and training, TVET, at the barangay level. Speaking with the local chief executive at the Doucette Tani Hotel on April 30, Ashray A. Banto, regional director of TESDA Davao, revealed that the agency needs help with community-based training programs, including identification, funding, and inclusivity. National News. Filipino researcher and expert said on Saturday, May 4, 2024, that the marine life in Sandy Cay in the West Philippine Sea is already in a degraded state. A study conducted by the University of the Philippines, UP, Institute of Biology, in Sandy Case 1, 2, 3, and 4, from March 20 to March 23, showed dead corals piled higher than a person atop live corals. It was also found that there is a low fish diversity and abundance and low coral diversity in the area. It was also noted that most corals in Sandy Cay 2 and 3 are small massive forms with few live digitate debranching forms in deep waters. The United States, Japan, Australia, and Philippines have called out China as they express serious concerns about the situation in the East and South China Sea, West Philippine Sea. In a joint statement following a meeting in Hawaii, Australian Deputy Prime Minister and Prime Minister for Defense Richard Marles, Japanese Minister of Defense Kihara Munuro, the Philippine Secretary of National Defense Gilberto Teodoro, and U.S. Secretary of Defense Lloyd Austin III expressed strong objections to China's dangerous use of coast guards and maritime militia vessel in the South China Sea. They noted China's repeated obstruction of Philippine vessels, exercise of high seas freedom of navigation, and disruption of supply lines to Second Tomas Sual, which constitute dangerous and destabilizing conduct. International news. On 2 of January, a young Ukrainian weapon inspector, Kristina Kimakot, got word that an unusual-looking missile had crashed into a building in the city of Kharkiv. She began calling her contacts in the Ukrainian military, desperate to get her on it. Within a week, she had mangled debris splayed out in front of her at the secure location in the capital, Kyiv. She began taking it apart and photographing every piece, including the screw and computer chips smaller than her fingernails. She could tell almost immediately this was not a Russian missile, but her challenge was to prove it. Buried amidst the mess of metal and spouting wires, Ms. Kamachok spotted a tiny character from the Korean alphabet. Then she came across a more telling detail. The number 112 had been stamped onto parts of the shell. This corresponds to the year 2023 in the North Korean calendar. She realized she was looking at the first piece of hard evidence that North Korean weapons were being used to attack her country. Three Indian nationals had been arrested and charged over the killing of Sikh separatist leader in Canada, which sparked a major diplomatic row between the two countries. Hardeep Shai Nizar, 45, was shot dead last June by masked gunmen in a busy car park in a Vancouver suburb. The diplomatic row escalated after Prime Minister Justin Trudeau alleged India's government may have been involved. Delhi strongly denied the allegation. Entertainment news. A family-owned piano business is finding creative ways to make use of discarded instruments by turning it into art. Played and Remade is a brainchild of John Kelly, owner of the piano shop Bath. He says that Somerset business is asked to scrap between 150 and 300 unwanted pianos a year, each of them destined for rubbish dumps. But the shop, which has previously worked with the band Coldplay and repurposing instruments, is offering the discarded pianos to artists for free so that they can turn them into works of art. Let's bolt in again to a super robot action in Baldur's 5 Legacy. Under the helm of esteemed director Mark Reyes, beginning May 6, weekdays at 4 p.m. on GMA Afternoon Prime, Pinoy Hits, and Capuso Stream. Relive the action fantasy and nostalgia as the groundbreaking series Baldur's 5 Legacy makes its most awaited returns this summer. Headlined by Capuso Ultimate Heartthrob Miguel Tan Felix, Isabel Ortega, Redson Flores, Rafael Ladchico, and Matt Luzano, the historic live-action adaptation will be replayed on GMA Afternoon Prime Time beginning May 6. Yesterday, April 16, GMA Network posted a teaser video of the comeback, which immediately gained positive reaction. Now, Abed's viewers can no longer wait to rewatch the epic series. According to some netizens on GMA Network's Facebook page, OMG! Wish granted, this is happening! I'm excited! Papanoorin ko ulit too! Happy na naman ang inner child ko! For the sports news, and Manchester City boss Pep Guardiola rather succinctly put it, 1 week left, 3 games left, 9 points and we will be champions. 7-6 or 3 points, Arsenal will win the Premier League. Guardiola is not placing much faith in Manchester United them, given the expect Arsenal to win every game and the Gunners visit Old Trafford on 12 of May. But then, he doesn't have to. If City win their final 3 games, they will go into the history books as the first team to win the English title in 4 successive seasons. For Erling Haaland goes against Wolves, ensured City navigated their latest obstacle with ease. Now, it is on the Craven Cottage of Fulham, a team they have beaten 15 times in a row. They finished with West Ham and at home. City have not dropped a point at Etihad Stadium against the Hammer since Guardiola arrived in 2016. In between comes a trip of Tottenham. City have not scored a Premier League goal or taken a point at Spurs' new stadium. They did win there in the FA Cup this season, though, and a Postiglou's team are in the terrible form. Todd Carlos and the Kremlin calls smashers, thus in the title hope of the Chivitigo crossover to make it to the 2024 VBL All-Filipino Conference Final. Defending champion Kremlin book a return trip to the finals of the PBL All-Filipino Conference, sending Chivitigo crushing out the contention with resounding 25-16, 25-21, 25-20 victory in the semifinals at the Smart Araneta Coliseum Sunday. This marks the seventh straight appearance of the Cool Smashers in the championship round of the All Filipino or Open Conference and their fifth time since the league turned professional in 2021. With the win, Creamline hiked its record to 2-1 with 7 points. Even in the event of a triple tie in the semis, standing the Cool Smashers point total will be more than good enough. Featured stories. From pirate heaven to ecological hotspot, Cuba's treasure island is far-flung, gem home to some of the Caribbean's rarest animals. A pirate hideaway, a one-time U.S. colony and biodiversity hotspots home to endangered crocs, parrots, sharks, and turtles, Cuba's Isla de la Juventud and is an enigma. The Caribbean nation's largest offshore island lies 60 miles south of the mainland and is a coma-shaped arc of palm and pine trees, citrus grove, and marble hills that few visitors ever see. In centuries past, real pirates of the Caribbean slipped into the island's coves with boats bearing illicit booty. Today's visitors come from the port of Batabano, 56 kilometers south of Havana, on a three-hour ferry ride that cost $0.50, Cuban pesos, 0.35, and requires reservation a month in advance or securing a seat on a regular flights. Before the Indian content creator Mr. Nobody Daddy made the terms Mekos Mekos, which literally means mix mix, popular on social media, the Philippines already had its own original version of it. A cold sweet desserts that is a sure fire hit, especially in extreme heat. Halo Halo, which some consider as the country's unofficial national dessert, is a popular cold dessert consisting a crushed ice and evaporated milk that are literally mixed with other ingredients. The ingredients usually include but are not limited to ube, leche flan, langka, sagu, gulaman, pinipig, minatamis na saging, sweetened banana, and minatamis na kamote, sweetened sweet potato. For the side stories, let's watch this. And for the trivia, do you know that Davao City is known for its thriving eagle conservation programs? Several organizations in Davao are dedicated to preserving and protecting the critically endangered Philippine eagle. That's all our news for today. Please like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated on the Pinoy Rab News channel. This is Gilbert Lopez Martiecaso. Good morning.